Hello friends, welcome to my super learning channel. Today I have yet another interesting topic to share with you. Let's get started. We have Office Addin's feature. I hope some of you already familiar with this. If not, this tutorial will help you. I have already prepared a set of sample data wherein I go and add the years and by person wise what are the sales being done. And I go to Office Addin. So this is, you can assume, like a sales data, and there are lot of other add-ins available within the store which has been categorized by different functionality, and you can also find the details about the add-in feature. So why this is required? So if you see the D3, which is a programmable visualized charts, but in this case we are not going to code or program anything, we are just going to use the readily available feature called E2D3. So this will create the intuitive chart for you easily. You could see there is an option for get it now, which can be used to integrate from the E2D3 site. And as soon as I select this and I hit the add button, it creates a panel for me to pick the various charts available that I can use around. Again, you can go for some of the familiar charts, like in this case I am going to take the dotted bar chart and see how this works. Since I have not selected any data, it is saying that I need to select the data, and I'll just go and pick the, but I just reset the data. Now my chart gets data sourced from the Excel or whatever I have selected already. Usually these charts are little bigger in size, so you can reduce if you want to see within the visible area of the chart. So one interesting thing you would have noticed is it has been shown by year wise and then how each person sales trend is. This is similar to the bar graph we are all familiar with, but the way it is being visualized is very appealing. And when you want to select this chart to move around, you need to click one of the corners. If you click anywhere, it will not move. Yeah. Pretty much looks like a normal graph. Now when I go and select the 2011, you could see how visually the data gets changed. Let me show you one more. You see the dots are just flying around and disappearing, and the new chart is placed or new bars are stacked for the corresponding year. And one more thing is how I can use this or share within my application, right? So for that, if you click this share your chart app option, then you will get share URL. You can do this to your social media, or there is a HTML code is available that you can embed into your blog or websites. So that way this chart can be used across outside the Excel. I will demonstrate one more example. Before that, I will clean up the data. And again, I am going to Office Addins. This time, I want to show you how the network diagram is prepared so easily. We all know the network diagrams or network topology, right? So it is more of a connections that we make from each or different nodes. In practical scenario, we also have these kind of network related data. And we want to see visually so that it makes sense. So in this case, I have not prepared any data. I am just going with the sample data given by the tool for the demonstration purpose. So as soon as I select the chart and I want to move this little bit up so that you can see it fully. I am inserting the sample data, making this as a lending amount. So a person lends from to another person, and what is the lending amount? Say Alice is giving Bob $500, and again he is giving to Bob in a different time, let's say $300. I'm just playing around with the numbers alone. I'm not changing the from and to name in this chart. $250 from Bob to Clara and Daniel to Clara. So $50. But if you see this, the chart was already selected, I mean from the previous column headers. So if I continue this, it will produce the graph based on my previous column names and the previous data, because that this wizard has already captured the data to produce the graph. You can see the value column is still shown here, and a chart is being drawn based on the previous data. Now I want to use the current data that I have created, right? So I will go and reset. Here you can see the lend amount is shown after we refresh the or reset the data. So if you see, Clara has lended money from Daniel and Alice has given $450 to Clara. My network diagram is representing how the data is structured or what the relationship that it makes. So here Clara has received $50 from Daniel, and Bob has given $50 to Clara, and Alice has given $450. Alice also given $800. If you see the data in row 2 and 3, it is 500 plus 300. So it has been automatically summed up, and the data is shown in the simple network diagram. The office